I think it's time that I finally talk about Austin Mahone.
What about love? What about our promises?
I have unfairly ignored this genius of pop music for way too long. His music is the stuff of legends, and yet he struggles to get the mainstream attention he so thoroughly deserves. My friend the Radical Douche has been singing his praises for a while now, and well, I think it's my turn to do the same. But what makes Austin Mahone the next pop god? What makes him one of the most talented musicians of our era? What makes his music the most incredible audio experience of the decade? I'm sorry, I can't do this anymore, I just can't. Yeah, we're not actually going to be talking about Austin Mahone today. Instead, we're going to be talking about a different teen idol, Shawn Mendes. Shawn Mendes made his big breakthrough last year with Stitches, which reached number 4 on the Hot 100. And then he made I Know What You Did Last Summer with a member of Fifth Harmony. That was pretty big too. And so far, I've kind of seen mixed reception for this guy. Some people hate him for being whiny and for essentially just being another Justin Bieber. But I think I kind of like this kid. He's not a particularly strong singer or even songwriter at times. He sounds whiny, even I can admit that. But what I like about the songs that I've heard from him is that he makes himself vulnerable. In Stitches, he's heartbroken from a breakup. In Summer, he's heartbroken because he got cheated on. It's not exactly a wide range of emotions, I know, but it's a teen heartthrob, and it gets the job done. But his latest single, let's just say that he's given up his biggest strength in my book.
'Cause I know I can treat you better.
This is Treat You Better, the lead-off single to Mendes' second studio album, Illuminate. And I hate this song. I hate it a lot. I've defended this guy in the past, but I have absolutely no defense of this. To me, this is basically a betrayal for ever considering myself a fan or just an apologist to this guy. It's about how you should be dating him and not some other guy. So, let's dig in, shall we? Hey, wait a minute. Isn't that the guitar riff to Don't Let Me Down? I'm getting off topic. Actually, in general, I think the instrumentation to this song is alright. It's kind of solid. It's not quite as organic as Mendes' other hits, but the melodies actually do sound nice. They have potential. The guitar lick on that post-chorus in particular is actually pretty intense, and it could have worked if it weren't for some other reasons. I'll get into those later.
I won't lie to you. I know he's just not right for you.
Ooh, breaking out our thesis statement right out of the gate, aren't we? Charming. Okay, let's play pretend for a little bit. Just pretend right now that I'm the girl that Mendes is singing to in this song. Just ignore the fact that I don't sound anything like a girl. Okay, tell me, Mendes. Why is the guy that I am dating not right for me? Go on.
And you could tell me if I'm off, but I see it on your face when you say that he's the one that you want.
Alright, kid, you already had an uphill battle the second you ever thought about writing a song as douchey as this. But the first half of the first verse has already made this song completely irredeemable. You say that you can tell on her face that she's lying to herself? That's not good enough. I thought that Robin Thicke already showed why it's a bad idea to just assume you know what a girl feels back in 2013. And you're in some pretty dangerous territory if you're wrong, buddy. But of course this song's gonna paint him like he's 100% right, even though he doesn't once explain what it is that's wrong with this girl's boyfriend, or why he would be better. And I think his handlers realized this after the song was released, and so they made the music video portray an abusive relationship. Now, admittedly, that is kind of a good reason to tell a girl to get out of a relationship. But seriously, just let the song do the talking. The music video shouldn't have to do the talking for you. And even if the song specified that this girl is being abused by her boyfriend, that doesn't change the fact that he wants her for herself.
I know I can treat you better than he can, and any girl like you deserves a gentleman.
So this chorus, this is where the song bombs hard. Not only because Shawn wants this girl all to himself, but because he insists that he's a gentleman. A perfect specimen ripe for dating. Even though he doesn't explain why beyond the super vague promise of treating her better. Whatever that means.
Tell me why are we wasting time on all your wasted crying when you should be with me instead?
What crying? You don't mention this anywhere else in the song, and it feels like a last-ditch effort to justify your awful jealousy. At this point, if she's crying, it's probably because you're trying to force her into a relationship she doesn't want to be in. But no, this is your song, so of course that's not what happens. Better than he can. Oh, that's right, Shawn. Scream to the world that you're perfect for her. The whole world deserves to know, they must know, of the injustice of you two not being together. Speaking of which, who is this girl again? By the way, this is part of the reason I feel the post-chorus is kind of wasted, because Mendes keeps doing this pitch-shifted screaming over it. I've been able to tolerate this kid's vocal tones in the past, even when he's been at his most screechy, but this is just unbearable. It's not even just what he's saying, it's the fact that it sounds so processed and loud. It's easily the worst audio moment of the entire song. As for worst moment overall, don't make me choose.
I'll stop time for you the second you say you'd like me to.
And then in the second verse, he doesn't even mention the other guy in the situation at all. It's all about him and his desires. And this girl is falling for it? Any girl would see how unbelievably selfish you are. You can't fool her by throwing in one line about her needs.
I just wanna give you the loving that you're missing.
But then you immediately follow that up with this.
Baby, just to wake up with you will be everything I need, and this could be so different.
So leave her the hell alone.
Give me a sign, take my hand, we'll be fine. Promise I won't let you down.
Wait a minute. I think I just figured it out. Don't Let Me Down and Treat You Better are both about each other. It's true, the Illuminati know! No, that would be dumb. That would be really dumb.
Just know that you don't have to do this alone.
You don't have to do this alone. Do what alone? No, seriously, as I've mentioned before, you've given me no real indication of what this girl is going through. You've given us no information, no reason to feel attached to these characters that you're making. You know, sometimes I harp on vague songwriting, especially in songs where they are basically about nothing, like Fight Song. But honestly, that's nothing compared to when the song is actually about something. It's a story, basically. You can't just say that there's something wrong here and not give any explanation or insight, not unless you actively do not want people on your side. This is basic songwriting and you are screwing it up. So overall, this is the worst Shawn Mendes song I've ever heard. Shawn's whiny throughout, and his whininess here makes him look like a prick. Which, you know, he probably is, because he's trying to be super controlling to someone who's already spoken for at the moment. For all we know, this could make him worse than the guy who's supposedly not treating this girl right. The only saving grace this song has is some of its instrumental moments, but even that's not enough to save this from being a train wreck. I think I stood up for you, Shawn. Didn't have to be like this. Take care.